programmable logic controller trainer from the Tesca. The order code for this trainer kit is 52017. PLCs are very useful and essential in today's industrial scenario. The programmable logic controller or PLC is an industrial computer used in preferably automations and control of process.
So this is the trainer kit of programmable logic controller trainer. Order code for this trainer kit is 52017. In this we are using a Delta DVP PS02 PLC to perform this experiment. User manual and patch codes are also included with this kit. In this trainer kit, we are using Delta's DVP14SS2 processor. This is a PLC with 8 inputs and 5 outputs. For this trainer, here this is the 24 volt DC supply. These are the input terminals from the PLC, and this is the 24 volt DC supply for output side, and these are the output terminals of the PLC. There are also, we are providing 4 NO switches, 4 NC switches and 4 NO switches as well. These are latch NO switches. These NO switches, the one terminal is common from all the switches, and the other terminal we will use as per requirement for the programming. So in this trainer kit, the NO switches work when the supply is provided to the any terminal. And there are also annunciators. These LEDs will prompt, and these are giving with idea as in industrial environment how we can use the different types of products with to control with the PLCs. These are motor, control valve, electric pump, electric heater, solenoid valve, etc. These are provided to understand how the PLC control these objects in the industrial environment. So this processor of Delta company, this will be worked as syncing and sourcing in both mode. For syncing operation, we have to provide negative input to the SS terminal of the input PLC, and for sourcing input we have to provide positive terminal to the SS terminal of the PLC. So when we use in sourcing output, when we use it in sourcing input mode, the 24 volt supply will be come out from the PLC, and when we use it in syncing mode, the 24 volt positive supply will be goes into the PLC. So now for connecting the terminals, first we have to power on the supply. Now for connections, first we have to power on the supply. The PLC is on, we can see. Now we are using the syncing mode. So for this we use 24 volt supply to the common terminal of NO switches. The other terminal of NO switch will goes to act as an input, whatever we consider for the programming, and the negative terminal of 24 volt supply will be goes to SS terminal. So these are the connections. Now for the output side of PLC, first we have to common the C0 and C1 with the positive and the output what we are using, whether we take either Y0 or we can place it any of the annunciator to understand when the output will work. Now Further, we have to program the PLC to execute these operations. So, in this trainer kit, the enunciator LEDs are connected to the positive 24 volt. So, we have to provide negative input to the common terminals of the output side. We have to common the C0 and C1 as well. And the negative output will come from Y0 or whatever we output select, and this will show on the supply at whatever we select in the annunciators. So now for the programming, we are going to use Delta's WPL soft 2.37. Now, for programming of this PLC, first we have to communicate this PLC with the PC. For communication, we are providing RS232 interface cable, which be connected at this port. Then the other port of USB adapters will be connect to the PC. Now, after opening the WPL soft Delta's programming software, first we have to select the RS232 communication settings. Here, the USB. Now for programming with this PLC, we first go to communication settings and select RS232. Here we can select the COM port. Here we can see USB to serial COM port is showing at COM 11. So we select the COM 11 and auto detect the PLC. So the result of detecting is shown at the window. The PLC is SS2, which are of model, and the protocol as shown. So now for programming, first we have to select new. Now we select here the processor, which is our series of SS series. The communication settings are RS232, COM 11, which is auto detected by the program. Now the file name, whatever we want to give the file name, we can give and select OK. Here there are the three types of modes to programming. There is the ladder diagramming, ladder diagram mode, instruction list mode, and there is also SFC, sequential flow chart mode, which will be used as per requirement. So now at this time we are going to use ladder programming. So for programming a program, first we select F1, which is an input device instruction. For this we can use X0, which is the zero number of input from the PLC. So we can select OK, and now we select the output. Output is Y0. It is input device instruction and output coil. So output coil Y0 we select here and press OK. Now this is the NC logic which are made at the programming. Now for this the programming has done, so we have to end this programming instruction. For this we can select F6. In this API list we here search end instruction and press OK. So this programming run has been end. Now we will compile the software, and the ladder instruction, from there we can compile this. The compiler has performed his compilation and compiling is complete. We can see here the dialog for compiling is completed. Now we have to download this program to the PLC. So for this we can go to this icon. Here we can show write to PLC. So we are going to write this PLC. This is the transfer setup which can give communication mode, whether we are going to use PC to PLC or PLC to PC and PC to HPP. In this we are select PC to PLC. Now press OK. So
In this time, the PLC is in running mode, so the program will automatically change the PLC's status to the stop, and then we stop. So from this icon we can write to program to the PLC. The transfer setup is shown here. In communication mode we will select PC to PLC and press OK. Now the program has been write to PLC, and now we are start the online mode. So the online mode shows the PLC is in stop mode. We have to turn on the PLC to run mode. For this we going to communication and press the run. The PLC run confirm, yes. Now the program is in run mode. So at this kit, as we press the NO switch, the output will come out and it will showing the motor is running. We can see the simulation in the program as well. As we press the input is X0, and simultaneously output also come at the same time. Thank you. So this is the NO switches operation we have shown here. As we press the NO switch, the output will come, the output will high. As we remove the supply from the input, the output will low. So here are also provide NC switches. For this we just change the connection to NC switch, the common terminal and the other terminal of input. Now in NC condition we do not press the switch, but the supply continues and output come and output goes to high, and as we press the switch the output goes to low. We can see there, this is the NC operation. And now for the NO latch switch we can further connect the common terminal to the 24 volt and the other terminal for input. Now this is the latch switch. This is latch switch. When we continually press the switch, the output will come, and as we release the switch, the output goes low. This is the operation of latch NO switch.